Hey, I'm making a vlog
again.
Yeah, so it's Sunday morning. Nope, I lied, sorry, it's Sunday evening, Sunday afternoon. It's pretty much already getting to Sunday evening. Anyway, I was out all day collecting some supplies from various places for a project that I thought of.
What's the project, you ask? Well, what? So, I'll show you all the pieces I got and see if you can piece it together. So I got this black bristle board here. I got this picture frame with a two-pane glass dealy. I got soldering irons, and this stuff I already had from before, soldering iron and a hot glue gun. And then I got some other assortments of things. Got a USB cable that I'm going to be using for wire. Going to be cracking that open. Got scotch tape. Got thumbtacks. Scissors. And the important part, an LED puck. Ooh, that's bright, eh? Whoa. And the one important piece for all this puzzle is in this little package here. And if I can just get this open. Inside this package, we have an Apple logo, but I'm actually going to be using its little brother, the smaller Apple logo. So yeah, so right now all these pieces may not look like much, but when I'm done, you'll see how it's going to look. Hopefully it turns out decent.
I also forgot to mention one very important part of the pieces that I just listed, and that's the DC power adapter. Unfortunately, I can't really show you that because I forgot it in the car, but you'll see it when everything is all done.
So what I did so far was I took this glass out of the picture frame. I don't know if you can see it, it's like right there. And I just traced around it with a pen. See that very faintly? So I could match this black bristle board to the actual frame size. I just cut that black bristle board out, like I said, and it actually does fit in the frame. So far, so good. So next, I got the Apple logo centered on the black bristle board, held together with the scotch tape, and the towel actually serves a very important purpose, because next, we have to get the thumbtacks to actually poke around this template. Thumbtacks are black and white, so I'll use a white one because I like it. There, so the white tack was used to poke holes all around the design. Don't know if you can see it, but there's actually holes poked there. I just traced around the logo again with pen, so now I have to just cut out that shape. So I cut out the Apple logo, and actually you can probably use that one over there for something else. Now all I was left to do is put a piece of white paper behind this, and once the LEDs are all in there, it should glow very nicely. So the back paper is taped on to the back, and that's how the front looks, essentially. So we are pretty much done. Now, just for the hard part, basically have to disassemble this LED puck and position some LEDs. So looking at the LED puck's power source, it has powered by 3 1.5 volt batteries. So that's 4.5 volts, so which means it could safely handle 5 volts, which our power supply is able to output. And we can also repurpose this handy little button for turning on the on-off the LEDs once they're in their new home. So took apart the LED enclosure, and all it is LEDs, surprise, surprise, a power switch, and all the LEDs seem to be wired in parallel with a very tiny resistor. We got to figure out the value of that resistor. And it's right there. I don't know if the camera can even focus on it, but it's right there. So the easy part will be desoldering these LEDs, but the hard part would be trying to drill through this casing to fit the LEDs in there, especially when I don't have a drill. So I think I'm going to have to go out to Canadian Tire and find something that would actually work for that purpose. So I'll be back. Hey, I'm back. So I got the adapter from the car, which I needed. I also had to go to Canadian Tire to get this much needed drill bit. Had to spend a bit much on, like, $8 for this piece of crap. But the only way I could use it is I have to have an impact drill, which, fortunately for me, I do have. I actually won this bad boy in a tool draw at an old place I used to work at a long time ago. But it will fit that, and I can drill my holes for my LEDs. Soldering iron and glue gun warm up. Hopefully I have enough glue sticks to complete this project, because I don't want to go back to store and buy glue sticks, because it's already adding up to be an expensive project already. So I've desoldered some of the LEDs on here, and I've used that tool there to drill holes in the bezel here, and I've placed the LEDs in there. So all the wiring will be on the back here, and the light will shine out through here. So all the LEDs are now in position in the frame, all around like so. So now I just have to do the daunting task of wiring them all up. Since I don't have any wire, this is where the USB cord comes in. I'm going to chop the ends off, take the jacket off, and use wire inside for connecting wire for the LEDs.
Oh boy. This is taking so long to solder these connections.
I only got the anodes soldered on one side so far. Using DVDs to hold it up. So we got all the LEDs in place now, and everything is all soldered up. We just got to solder on the power switch, power, and the current limiting resistor, and then we're all good to go. Say hi to Alex.
Hi. Now go away.
Okay. It's like you guys. So yeah, this thing looks like a lop of shit right now, but hopefully it all fits in there. And this casing, and it'll all be nice and dandy and good to go. So, fingers crossed. Many hours later, I finished the Apple logo. It's not 100% perfect, but it's a start. Definitely some more visions I have to work on for it could be in its final stage. But that's how it looks in the dark. Cardboard on the back here to try and cut down on some of the light leakage. So hopefully that works out pretty good. So after adding the cardboard to the back, it's definitely cut down a lot on the light leakage. So now there's the final product.